the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Father, we invoke your holy name and seek your gracious blessing as we begin this 60th commencement of Bishop O'Connell High School. Our hearts are filled with gratitude, joy, and hope. We give you thanks for the priceless blessing of Catholic education, for the parents who have sacrificed much so that their sons and daughters could be formed, body, intellect, and soul in the ways of your truth and love, and for the administration, faculty, and staff of Bishop O'Connell High School, who have been offered to and received by our graduates. We're experiencing deep joy today as we witness these graduates of Bishop O'Connell High School attain the goal which they have been pursuing these past 4 years. We know the pride which fills our hearts in their accomplishments, and sense the pride which these graduates are also experiencing this day as they move forward to commence another chapter in their young lives. We pray with profound hope in your loving care for each of these graduates. Bless them abundantly each day and make prosperous their endeavors, so in all the remaining stages of their earthly journey, they will use their talents and skills for your glory and the welfare of others. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Welcome to all of you watching this on May 28th with the class of 2020. And to all of you who will view this graduation ceremony in the weeks and months and years ahead. We appreciate you joining us for the 60th commencement exercises of Bishop Dennis J. O'Connell High School. Parents and guardians, thank you for entrusting your sons and daughters to us and for providing them with the life foundation of a Catholic education at the high school level. Find joy and rightful pride in the fine young men and women they have become. Continue to guide and nurture them on their path to full adulthood. No one can ever fill the precise role that you do in their lives. Colleagues, faculty, administration, staff members, all those who form the community of adults at O'Connell, congratulations and thank you for the love and devotion you offer to every O'Connell student, but especially to the class of 2020. The bond you and those who came before you have formed with them is unique. There is a lifelong connectedness created by the experiences you have shared and the efforts you have made to draw out and develop their many gifts and talents. Enjoy the memories and the hope of this day with them. Seniors, class of 2020, soon to be the newest graduates of Bishop O'Connell High School. Congratulations. Value the friendships you have formed, the lessons you have learned, the strong community you have shared in over these past 4 years. Wherever you go, whatever you do, stay connected in some way to O'Connell, to its tradition and its legacy. Go out and do good. Stay close to God. Continue to learn. Grow in wisdom. Offer service. Use the gifts and talents you have been given. Become all that you can be. With those goals in mind, let us begin our graduation ceremony for the Bishop O'Connell Class of 2020.
Most Reverend Michael F. Burbidge was born in 1957 in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. He attended Catholic grade schools and graduated from Cardinal O'Hara High School, Springfield, Pennsylvania, in 1975. After high school, he went to St. Charles Borromeo Seminary and was ordained a priest of the Archdiocese of Philadelphia in 1984. Bishop Burbidge holds a BA in philosophy and an MA in theology from St. Charles Borromeo, an MA in education administration from Villanova University, and a doctorate in education from Immaculata College. Father Burbidge's first priestly assignment was as parochial vicar of St. Bernard Church in Philadelphia. He has served on the faculties of Cardinal O'Hara High School, Archbishop Wood High School, and St. Charles Borromeo Seminary as the Dean of Students. In 1992, Father Burbidge was named Administrative Secretary to the Archbishop of Philadelphia and served in that capacity until 1999. In 2002, he was ordained an Auxiliary Bishop of Philadelphia. In June 2006, Pope Benedict XVI named Bishop Burbidge the fifth bishop of the Catholic Diocese of Raleigh, North Carolina. In 2016, he was announced by Pope Francis as the fourth bishop of the Catholic Diocese of Arlington and was installed on December 6, 2016 at the Cathedral of St. Thomas More. Bishop O'Connell has been blessed with many visits from Bishop Burbidge over the past 4 years, and we are thankful he was able to send us the following video to be a part of the ceremonies today.
Dear graduates, first of all, sincere congratulations to all of you. From my visits with you over these past several years, I hope you know how much I have appreciated getting to know you and visiting with you whenever I could. Those visits brought me great joy. I fully understand that your high school graduation experience is radically different because of the COVID-19 pandemic. And I know this is disappointing for you, and I share that disappointment. But dear graduates, as we take note of your accomplishments in this virtual way, let me submit that the challenges of the past 2 months made your earning of these diplomas even more significant. You have navigated uncertainty, disruption, and separation in ways that have strengthened your resilience, and I hope your faith as well. Along with your parents and teachers, you have, to use a slogan from the United States Marine Corps, improvise, adapt it, and overcome. With that mindset, perhaps without realizing it, you have developed skills and a resilience that will serve you well when facing future challenges. I also imagine that you have proven yourselves capable of doing things you did not know you could do. Early on in this pandemic, you had to accept that things were going to change, that we would not return to school, that there would be no prom, no spring sports, and no in-person graduation. I'm sure that coming to that acceptance was difficult. Yet, moved by the Holy Spirit, you persevered and found ways to serve others, to create personal protective equipment for healthcare workers, organize food drives, reach out to those who are confined, and serve your own families by helping your siblings and supporting your parents. And in doing so, You have demonstrated a profound love for the Lord and your neighbor. In the words of St. Faustina, your actions are explained this way. Love is a mystery that transforms everything it touches into beautiful things that are pleasing to God. In light of the fact that some uncertainty remains on the horizon, I encourage you in your prayer lives to continue asking the Lord to send forth the Holy Spirit to guide you through future uncertainties. Having been formed in faith and educated well in our diocesan high schools, you are called now to continue your preparation by further developing the gifts and talents God has given you so that you may use them in service to Him and to others. Congratulations, class of 2020. On your very special graduation day, know that I am proud of you, and my prayers are with you and with your parents and guardians and all who have been there for you along the way. I pray that this very special moment and this significant accomplishment is one you will celebrate joyfully and remember throughout your life. May you go forward applying what you have learned throughout your Catholic education and be transformed by the love of Christ now and always. Congratulations, dear graduates.
Good afternoon, O'Connell administration, faculty, staff, families, friends, and the class of 2020. I'm honored to speak to you as the salutatorian of the class of 2020. First, I would like to thank all of our parents and teachers for helping and encouraging us along our high school journey. I believe that I can speak for the entire class when I say, without such phenomenal influences in our lives, none of us would have made it to this day. Class of 2020, we did it. We have successfully finished high school. Every assignment that we have completed, every test we have taken, every experience we have had, has led us to this day. The day where our high school journey officially comes to an end and the next chapter of our lives begins. When I was little, I used to imagine what high school would be like. In all honesty, I thought it would be like High School Musical. As it turns out, my imagination was not too far off. Although everyone did not randomly begin singing and dancing in the hallways, we all had the chance to witness outstanding musicals, intense basketball games, energetic pep rallies, and memorable dances. Also, everything we did together. Whether it was painting our faces blue to support the football team, blowing up a million balloons to decorate the gym for Superdance, or singing Take Me Home, Country Road at the top of our lungs to bring us to victory in the pep rally. Together, we have made our high school journey what it was. And as a class, we have accomplished so much. This year, although circumstances prevented us from having Superdance, we are still able to raise nearly $50,000 to find a cure for cystic fibrosis. We also collected 17,469 cans in the Christ House Soup Drive, and our class alone completed over 3,000 service hours. I am proud to say that the unity of our O'Connell community and each individual's dedication to serving others has helped to create a better life for people all around the world. Mother Teresa once stated, "God doesn't require us to succeed. He only requires that you try." I can truthfully say that our class, Bishop O'Connell's class of 2020, gave 150% effort in everything we did, from sports to school to service. Whether we won or lost, whether we passed or failed, we succeeded in God's eyes because we always tried our best. Our efforts often paid off. Our softball team won its 8th consecutive state title last year. Our girls' cross-country team won first place in the state championship this year. And 15 of our classmates committed to play a sport in college. That is only to name a few of the many different ways our class has both succeeded and persevered over the years. We must always remember that nothing, not even a pandemic, can overshadow all that we have accomplished. Father Theodore Hesburgh, former president of the University of Notre Dame, claimed, "The very essence of leadership is that you have to have vision." Class of 2020, we have that vision. In what seems like the blink of an eye, we went from being small, clueless freshmen to being seniors,
the leaders of the school. From participating in night-to-night mentoring, to helping at freshman orientation, to organizing all the school's events, we became the leaders that we have always looked up to. By leading with both resilience and strength, we have set a precedent for future classes to follow. I once read that graduation isn't an end, it's a beginning. This takes me back to freshman year, the beginning of our high school journey. On the first day of freshman orientation, after navigating what seemed like a maze and being guided by several kind yet very intimidating seniors, I finally made it to advisory. I walked in knowing no one and sat quietly in my chair as a million thoughts rushed through my mind. In all honesty, I was rather uncomfortable sitting there in a room full of complete strangers, but I was equally curious to see what relationships I would form with each of them. In the midst of my daze, the boy behind me interrupted me and asked for my Snapchat. I later came to know that this boy was Ethan. Throughout the years, I have come to know each of the strangers who sat in room 324 on the very first day of freshman orientation. I would like to believe that each of us had a similar experience in witnessing total strangers becoming our closest friends, an unfamiliar building becoming a home, and those seniors flexing their white polos in the hallways becoming us. It is truly remarkable to look back and see how far we have come over the past 4 years. Together, we have grown in faith, in knowledge, in wisdom, in courage, and in strength. Although we will all move on and go our separate ways, our time at O'Connell will always remain a part of us. Class of 2020, we are resilient, and I have no doubt that we will go on to do amazing things. Thank you all, and God bless.
Gratia. Good afternoon, family and friends, parents and teachers, administrators and faculty, and most importantly, the class of 2020. I am truly honored to speak to you on the special occasion of our graduation. After our 4 years together of hard work and perseverance, it is surreal that we have finally come to this moment. Although we cannot be together today in person, we need to recognize and celebrate such an achievement. Frankly, we did it, and we should be proud. Now, I would like to start by posing a question to all of you, a question that one of F. Scott Fitzgerald's esteemed characters from The Great Gatsby once prompted. What'll we do with ourselves this afternoon, and the day after that, and the next 30 years? When I found out I would be presenting this speech, I realized my task was to address what the future holds for us graduates. And with that, I felt like I had to have some great answer to Daisy Buchanan's simple question. Yet the fact of the matter is, I do not know what the future holds for us. For one, the impacts of a global crisis are still unfolding. We are living in such an unprecedented time where I cannot look to the past to provide a sufficient answer. Secondly, we are at the stage of our lives where there is a vast world of possibilities. No one can predict what is to come for us, not even ourselves. Yet these considerations should not intimidate us. We should be excited by the road not yet taken. We should be excited by the limitless opportunities ahead of us. We should be excited that our actions are going to mean something significant, not only in our lives, but also in the lives of others. We should be excited by the unknown, our future. To tell you a quick story, I was in New York City one afternoon, and I had just gotten off of the subway near Madison Square Garden. I was heading home, going to catch a bus, after spending the past couple of days in the city. Then all of a sudden, I felt a forceful nudge into my back. Immediately, I was so prepared to turn around and glare. However, I did not. Because when I looked back, I saw a man in dark sunglasses holding out a white cane, simply asking me for directions toward a specific avenue. I did my best to guide him where to go and watched as he crossed the street and wandered into yet another crowd. He made another checkpoint for himself, asking another person confidently for further directions, and proceeded again to be on his way. I walked away to the bus stop, reflecting. How did the man possess such a joy and fearlessness amid all of the uncertainties that came with his every step and interaction? How had he shown confidence rather than fear? A short time later, I found myself on the bus waiting for it to depart. I was soon taken aback to find that that same blind man had entered the bus and had taken the seat right in front of me. He stood out to me, not because of the sunglasses or the white cane, but because he carried himself with such a confidence and fearlessness. Now, as crazy of a coincidence as it may seem, this man resonated with me, and I think he exemplifies something that we can all apply in our own lives. In the midst of uncertainty, we must not shy away, but rather fearlessly take up and welcome the unknown. Our future is one large question mark, especially as we experience a pandemic. We do not know when, how, or if things will be back to normal. And yet, there is a remarkable beauty in that. The beauty is that in times when there is no precedent, we get to set it ourselves. Yes, we, the class of 2020, get to set the precedent ourselves. I know what I am saying may come off as overly optimistic, and it is inevitable that you will have your doubts as you struggle with not being able to know what is to come. I am not going to ignore that and pretend like I do not have those emotions too. So I challenge us together to fearlessly accept our doubts, our hesitations, and our frustrations, and together lean even more on faith and the fact that God has a plan. In a letter to the exile sent by Jeremiah, the Lord reminds us of his presence as he states, For I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. His words emphasize that no matter the uncertainty, we will always have the support that we need through him and the plan that he has for us. I have watched this class excel in so many ways. We are state champions. We are NASA satellite engineers. We are outstanding artists and performers. We are generous community service leaders. We are passionate super dancers, and the list could continue. Importantly, though, we are ourselves, full of potential and our very own special talents. Because of that fact, we have no reason to fear the unknown. If we handle it with the confidence that we rightfully should possess, nothing can stop us. So, let us embrace the future head on and without fear. Let us remember freshman year, walking out of the gym into the lobby, not knowing what to expect, only to find ourselves being applauded by our wonderful teachers that we will always thank and remember as some of our biggest supporters. At that time, we began our journey into the unknown of the coming 4 years. We were mixes of emotions, excited, anxious, nervous, among others. But we leave here today as graduates, walking through a new gym lobby of our lives, not knowing what to expect, but knowing that we are supported by those around us, by God, and by our own capabilities. We may not know the answer to the question from the Great Gatsby, but we do know that what lies before us is beautiful in its own way, as it will be unplagued by our fears. Fitzgerald centers his novel around a time of human joy and prosperity, and I want it to be clear that this will come. Our own personal roaring 20s are on the horizon, and I cannot wait to see where the unknown will lead us, the class of 2020. Thank you.
Dr. Joseph Vorbach is the superintendent of Catholic schools in the Diocese of Arlington. He is also a 1983 graduate of Bishop O'Connell High School. He received his bachelor's degree in government from the United States Coast Guard Academy, a master's degree and a doctorate in international relations from Tufts University, and a master's degree in education from Marymount University. After a 20-year career in the Coast Guard, Dr. Vorbach served on the faculty at the National Defense University. In 2008, he joined us here at Bishop O'Connell, serving first as principal and later as head of school. In 2019, he was named as superintendent of school here in Arlington.
Dear graduates of the class of 2020 at Bishop O'Connell High School, I extend to you my congratulations. I extend it further to your parents and all your loved ones out there who join you in celebrating this opportunity. One of the hard and sad things for me in the last number of months has been the fact that I wasn't around for your senior year. But I thought at the time, I'll be able to be with you at your graduation. And that hasn't turned out to be quite possible either, but I'm very happy to be here with you virtually. And I wanted to take the opportunity as superintendent of schools to remind you that in addition to your family, your friends, all your loved ones who celebrate this great accomplishment with you, that all around the diocese, there are folks remembering you from class in the parish school, from your youth ministry experiences, from CCD classes you may have been part of, scoutmasters and others, coaches, all folks who are aware that you're graduating and very happy for you and celebrating that with you from a distance. I congratulate you all and I welcome you to the great community of alums of Bishop O'Connell High School.
Special awards for academic excellence are presented to the following outstanding students. Mr. Matthew Rose, Chairperson of the Religion Department, determines that the Religion Award goes to Charles Douglas Stabileski. Mrs. Courtney Lewicki, Chairperson of the English Department, determines that the English Award goes to Lillian Elaine Brunero. Mr. Jeff Rickson, chairperson of the Social Studies Department, determines that the Social Studies Award goes to Catherine Tweetine Pham. Mrs. Adrienne Cunningham, chairperson of the World Language Department, determines the awards for world language. The French Award goes to Kieris Adelis Alvarado Rojas. The German Award goes to Corey Fritz Knopf. The Latin Award goes to Elisa Francine Keegan. The Spanish Award is presented to Cecilia Juarez. Mr. Thomas Glynn, chairperson of the Science Department, determines the awards for science. The Biology Award goes to Kendall Leona McBride. The Chemistry Award goes to Connor Thaddeus Owen. The Physics Award goes to Nathan Frederick Lindley. Mr. Michael Bernhardt, chairperson of the Mathematics Department, determines the Mathematics Award goes to Peter Assad Saliba. Mrs. Maria O'Malley, chairperson of the Business Department, determines the awards for business. The Business and Finance Award goes to Brendan W. Fielman. The Computer Science Award goes to Kiki Liu. Mr. Timothy LaCrosse, chairperson of the Fine Arts Department, determines the awards for fine arts. The Art Award is presented to Martha Claire Gaudet. The Instrumental Award is presented to Mark Arthur Brown, Jr. The Chorus Award is presented to Grace Catherine Feeney Rafferty. And the Drama Award goes to Madeline A. Johnson. The Student Athlete Award. This award is given to a female and male student who have excelled in a varsity sport for two or more years and have maintained a 3.5 cumulative grade point average. This award is presented to Sky Michelle Ferris and Brendan W. Fielman. The Gertrude Kennedy Award. This award is given in memory of Gertrude Kennedy, former chairperson of the counseling department, to a female and male student selected by the faculty administration, whose growth and development clearly exemplifies the mission statement of Bishop O'Connell High School. This award is presented to Jordan Amir Brown and Emily Quigley. The Immaculata Award. This award is given to a female and male student for consistent evidence of living the Christian life and attempting to put the gospel into practice. This award is presented to Charles Douglas Stabilaski and Angela Elizabeth Lucchetti. The Al Birch Award. This award is given in honor of former teacher and principal Al Birch for outstanding spirit and exuberance in the O'Connell community. This award is presented to Corey Fritz Knopf and Regina Lucia Pisano. The award for outstanding leadership goes to the executive members of the Student Council Association, Deborah Raquel Corneo, Nicholas John Slovak, Natalie Irene Lychek, and Espressa Bukai. Sister Catherine, Dean of Academics, will present the General Excellence Medals.
The General Excellence Medals are presented to the students with the highest academic achievement in the class of 2020. Alphabetically, they are Kieris Adelis Alvarado Rojas, Lillian Elaine Bernero, Sky Michelle Ferris, Cecilia Juarez, Alyssa Francine Keegan, Abigail Ann Kinsella, Kendall Leona McBride, Connor Thaddeus Owen, Ashley Marie Schmidt, Caitlin Marie Thompson. Now for the presentation of diplomas. Graduates who are members of the Bishop John J. Russell Chapter of the National Honor Society will have that designated below their photograph. Character, scholarship, leadership, and service are core qualities of the National Honor Society. The Global Studies Program is an initiative unique to Bishop O'Connell High School. From sophomore through senior year, each student participates in an individualized combination of learning experiences beyond the classroom, focused on themes of world importance in our time. Students have completed the equivalent of a ninth semester of academic work and created capstone presentations capturing what they have learned from their global studies experience. Certificates are presented for faith and humanitarian issues, global business and finance, language and culture, health and environmental issues, arts and humanities, and global politics. They are so designated. Having satisfactorily completed the course of studies offered by the Diocese of Arlington and prescribed by the Virginia Board of Education, the following students are awarded diplomas.
Gabriella Maria Adamo. Kareem Robert Jude Al-Quraishi. Kiaris Adelis Alvarado Rojas. Sydney Lauren Amos. Caitlin Barbara Anderson. Ryan James Anderson. Fiona Joan Archer. Natalie Virginia Archer. Alithia Lauren Arif. Alex Nathan Ashenbrunner. Joseph Allen Ashenbrunner. Jasmine Renee Avens. Meredith Jordan Bacon. Christopher D'Amatos Diogo Bagenda. Claire Elizabeth Bailey. Daniel Scott Bailey. Keaton Laura Ballard. John Lewis Baruch. Madeline Mildred Bates. Layla D. Berdut. Lillian Elaine Bernero. Jake Richard Berry. Ellen Taylor Betts. Anna Dominica Biernacki. Nathan Tefes Bizawork. Daniel J. Bobbolts. Ann Wiley Boniface. Daniel Joseph Bothwell. Emma Claire Bourne. Beckett Shanahan Brakefield. Aubrey Livana Brie Dotel. Abigail Rose Brooks. Darius Anthony Brown. Jordan Amir Brown. Mark Arthur Brown Jr.
Michaela Ibella Brune Benavides. Shpresha Buchai.
Bridget Burgos. Anna Catherine Burns. Jackson Everett Burnside. Aiden James Byrne. Eleanor Jean Caffey. Daniel William Cahill. Joseph A. Callahan. Joseph Antonio Capretta. Michael Collins Karsha. Josephine Casey Cartolicchio. Rebecca Cynthia Chase.
Hui Chi Chen.
Maurice Demetrius Clark.
Grace Elizabeth Klukey.
Stephen Joseph Cobb. Veronica Cole. Jonathan Alexander Collins. Lauren Anna Collins. Jared Allen Cooper. Benjamin Cooper Corbett. Mason Stephen Corby. Cristiano A. Cornicelli. Deborah Raquel Cornejo. Grace Miller Cornman. Jonathan Eric Craddock. Sarah Catherine Crockett. Calvin Kennedy Cunningham. Sarah Jane David. John Ryan Day. Zachary Burr Dealey. Samuel Woldu Desta. Victoria Amani Dickey. Aiden J. Dittmer. Gabriela Sofia Dominguez. James Irvin Ebrin. Edward Joseph Isert. Andrew Dominic Emmanuel. Christian Alexander Escalante. Sky Michelle Ferris. Brendan W. Fielman. Catherine Elizabeth Finnegan. Cormac Gabriel Flanagan. Mark Joseph Fogelson. Donald Jerome Gallagher. Kyle Matthew Gallagher. Francis Woolsey Gallagher IV. Michael Abraham Gallo. Jerry Carlson Guerin. Sophie Elizabeth Garzion. Martha Claire Godet. Jose Alejandro Gauto. Isabel Andrea Gentry. Benjamin Carter Gibbons. Luke Eric Joya. Paul Daly Glencher. Catherine Marie Glynn. Michelle Joyce Gomes. Thomas Gilmer Grattan. David Jordan Green. Kevin L. Guillen, Mateo Donovan Gutierrez, Nicolas Andres Guzon, Camille Noel Hall, Eden Grace Hall, Henry Shepherd Hamilton, Charles Edward Harris III, Elizabeth Jane Hart, Alyssa Keiko Hayashi, Dimitri Hayek, Brendan Diego Himes, Joshua Kamakana Heitzman, An Nam Huang, Campbell Josie Hodges, Sydney Michael Holland, Madeline Sue Horner, Thomas Robert Howard, Joseph Ernesto Yenzi, Eden Leanne Ingram, Rodney Rommel Jackson, Asia Lorene James, Madeline A. Johnson, Jack R. Jones, Courtney Alexis Jones, William Ward Jones, William Joseph Jones, Cecilia Juarez, Matab Singh Kahlo, Georgia Campbell Katsapis, Alyssa Francine Keegan, Olivier Kenol, Brandon A. Kim, Emily Sukyung Kim, Abigail Ann Kinsella, Andrew Joseph Clote, Corey Fritz Knopf, Daniel Edward Kester, Isabella M. Cooper, Adam L. Kufka, Maya Isabel Landeros, Catherine Isabella Lawrence, Matthew John Lettieri, Nathan Frederick Lindley, Peter Stephen Lobaugh, Aaron Joe Loftus, Percy Tommy Lopez, Joseph Peter Loden, Keith Gary Lowry, Michael John Lowry, Kiki Liu, Stevens Arcede Lucchesi. Angelina Elizabeth Lucchetti. Chen Ri Luo. Natalie Irene Lychek. Sophia Christina Maceo. Genevieve Rose Maiden. Daniela Elizabeth Manzano. Gabriel Ethan Martinez. Minerva Martinez Acosta. William Beckman Marzullo. Brianna Yvette Mata-Rivas. Kendall Leona McBride. Gardner Curry McCabe. Connor James McAllister. Valencia H. McIntosh. Jenna Lauren McKibben. Kaylee Marie McLaughlin. Claire Brown McNamara. Nicholas R. Mee. Derek Ulysses Mejia. Henry F. Mitchell. William Edward Mullen. Grace Caroline Mern. Gregory William Nardacci. Cameron Namati. Kien Trung No. Bao Quoc Nguyen. Elizabeth Huang Nguyen. Luan Din Kak Nguyen. Mai An Nguyen. Stephen Hu Nguyen. Mary Baxter Nimi. Richard Samuel Nitschke. Jamie R. Nixon. Donna Derica Curanziza. Douglas Alberto Nova Jimenez. Harley Marie Parkinson O'Donnell. Maria Lan O'Brien. Megan K. O'Brien. Aiden Patrick O'Donovan. Riley Ernest O'Donovan. Pauline Marie Ariola Oteza. Connor Thaddeus Owen. Andres Martin Peñafiel. Sofia Maria del Carmen Perez Rubio. Rinaldin Wade Perkins Jr. Pedro Petkov Nato. Emma Louise Petrie. Catherine Thuy Tien Pham. Regina Luzio Pisano. Maria Angela Polisi, Jayla Nicole Poole, Wesley Abraham Porterfield, Jameer B. Prince, Yu-Jen Chu, Emily Quigley, Grace Catherine Feeney Rafferty, Robert Jr. Reynoso, Isaac F. Robertson III, Lisbeth Kristen Rojas, Jackson Paul Rolla, Anastasia Jean Rother, Nicholas David Rovira, Rafael Francesco Ruiz, Max Everett Ruland, Meadow Ann Sacadura, Amelia Elizabeth Safel, Peter Assad Saliba, Tarine Noel Samadani, Isaiah Jeremiah Sampson, Yaneli L. Santiesteban Terrazas, Ethan N. Sargi, Isabella Rose Schandelbauer, Ashley Marie Schmidt, Francis Rose Selden, David John Shank, Peyton Shepherd, Micaiah Araya Simmons, Nicholas John Slovak, Benjamin Chester Smith, Abigail Marie Snarzik,
Gabrielle Mercedes Soule,
Charles Douglas Stabileski, Catherine Blanche Stamm, Prescott Christian Stark, Alexander Wade Stevenson, Naya Gabrielle Stewart, Joseph Richard Suarez, John Patrick Sullivan, Lara Claire Sunter, Natalie G. Susie Dallas, Prince Daniel Chow, Sabella Gurmai Tesfuzgi, Christian Aaron Tesnow, Caitlin Marie Thompson, Ben Fong Trin, Erica Anastasia Trujillo, Molly K. Turner, Ashley Aaron Turpin, Emily Rochelle Ulloa,
Catherine Margaret Van Belligham, David Paul Vaughn, Christopher Anthony Vaz, Madhumita Venkatesh, Cassina Louisa Vertel, Devin M. Vianney, Elizabeth Grace Vincey, Andrew William Vita, Alexander Agustin Voras, William Tien Phong Vu, Caroline Vanessa Wack, Lin Le Hua, Samuel Harley Walker, Ella Simone Walter, Victoria Beth Ward, Eva Jane Whitaker, Elise Hannelore Williams, Jalen Simone Woodridge, Mu Ren Shu, Joseph Anthony Young, Gwendolyn Marie Zork,
at Bishop O'Connell, we have a special tradition to allow legacy parents to hand the child's diploma to their graduating senior. This has always been a unique element of our graduation ceremony. Considering the conditions we are working under this year, we present the following video to honor this tradition.
Thank you.
Class of 2020, on behalf of Sister Lorraine and my colleagues whose tireless efforts in and out of the classroom you're well aware of, I thank you for the opportunity to be a part of your lives and growth over the past 4 years. This is a bittersweet day on a normal year as you celebrate the accomplishments of graduating high school and then face the change of no longer seeing each other every day in the hallways. And we're well aware of the circumstances that made this year particularly difficult, as we are unable to celebrate your accomplishments in a manner that you deserve or we expected. With that said, this has shown how resilient you are as a class and how talented you are as students, as you are able to succeed in your studies, overcome the obstacles, and remain leaders in your community through an unprecedented change. It has been a pleasure to watch you as a class mature as students, as young men and women, that rounded into true leaders in the school and in the community. It would take more time than I'm offered to list all of your accomplishments. So I'll congratulate you and remind you that we are quite proud of you and all that you have accomplished while you were here at Bishop O'Connell. As you go forward, remember to continue to do what made you successful here. Be bold, be magnanimous, caring, gracious, and resilient. Take these gifts with you and do great things. And as challenges mount, don't become overwhelmed by how far you have to go, but focus on how far you've come towards your goals already. Thank you again, and Godspeed.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. God our Father, you will all people to be saved and come to the knowledge of your truth. As we journey through life, inspire the hearts of your people, and especially these graduates, to continue the saving work of Christ everywhere until the end of time. Give us your blessings and graces to work together according to your plan of love, so that all of us may form that school of the gospel, the school of Christ your Son, who is the model of the human person made perfect. For he lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May Almighty God keep you from all harm and bless you with lasting joy. Amen. May he set his word in your heart and fill you with lasting joy. Amen. May you walk in his ways, always knowing what is right and good, until you enter in your heavenly inheritance. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit remain with you always, forever and ever. Amen.